Today I'm going to show you how to locate your Windows Part Key through your registry using a program that is freeware. This program is not dangerous, and basically it looks for Windows Part Keys. If you purchase the paid for version, then it looks for other programs' Part Keys. And the reason I'm doing this video is because recently I purchased a second computer, which is a Lenovo, and it's a manufactured computer, same as a Dell or Gateway and other computers that are manufactured. What they have done now with Windows 8 is that Microsoft has decided in its infinite wisdom that they were going to hide the Part Key because they thought that would reduce counterfeiting or people misusing the Part Key. And now the only thing that indicates that your system is genuine Windows is a tiny sticker that says Windows 8 on there, and it'll either be purple. And then it'll, if you move the tower or the sticker, it'll change the color of the sticker to blue. And they have a different color of sticker for each edition of Windows, whether it be Pro, Standard, or RT. And they have hidden the key in the BIOS for most manufacturer systems. So when you stick in a recovery disk from Lenovo or Dell, it'll automatically pick up the key from the BIOS and then install Windows and allow you to activate it. But there is a program out there that is freeware that will show you the key, and I will show you how to use it now. So as you can see, I already have the web page open to the program, and it's called Magical Jelly Bean Keyfinder. And as you can see, there are two versions, and this is a comparison chart to show the difference between the two products. On the left here we have the free version, and on the right we have the paid for version. And as you can see, the paid for version has more check marks, which means it can detect more keys and also do a little bit more for you. But the free version is good enough for what I wanted to do, and here it shows that it'll find Windows operating system, and it'll also work with 64-bit systems, and it will also do Office 2010 and Windows 7 and 8. Here they offer Adobe products, but of course we're using the free version, so you just go here and download it, and as you can see the price says free. Now I've already downloaded it and started the installation process, so you just click next, next, and then if you want a desktop icon you would click next. I don't really ever use a quick launch icon, so I of course left that unchecked. And here where it asks how you want to install express or custom installation, choose custom installation where my mouse is right now, and uncheck install search protect to set my home page and default search to conduit search. That to me is spyware, and it was detected as spyware in another program that it came with that I use. So I removed that from installing. That's why I chose the custom installation. And then click next. And then it basically just tells you what it's going to do. And then click install. And then as you can see, the box launch Keyfinder is checked. And already it has brought up my keys for Windows 8. 0.1 Pro, Microsoft Office Small Business, and then Winamp 5, which it didn't really mention on the website that it does bring up that key, but that isn't bad, and Windows Information. So as you can see, I've pixelated out the key, of course, all the other information that shouldn't be showing. But yeah, it does show you your CD key, the 25 character key that would allow you to activate and install Windows. If you want to save the information, you can just go to File and then Save As, and it'll save it as text to wherever you feel like. And once you've saved it, you would just go Exit. And it'll ask if you want to try the paid for program, and you just put don't show this dialog again and then click close, and you're done. Now that you're finished, you can always go to programs and features and remove it from your system. You will also want to check out the app data folder on your computer to remove any files or folders that it has left in there.
This can come in handy if you ever want to wipe out all of the Lenovo or manufacturer software, like Dell's software, support software, or Lenovo's support software, you can just get a copy of whatever version of Windows you have or edition. And for example, I'm using Windows Standard on the Lenovo, so or Windows Home, and then I would get a copy of just regular Windows 8 and then install it, and then I would have the key, and then I would activate it, and away you go. And that would eliminate the Lenovo support software, or if you bought a Dell or some other brand, their support software, and all the partitions that they create in order to do recovery.
Subscribe, follow, or visit my YouTube channel.